agree that by everything that we've heard this morning, you can harp on Honorable Perry's point of we are in unusual times, we're not in normal times. It means that as a country, we have the privilege, I must say, despite what got us here, it's a privilege to be part of charting a new path for football, which hopefully when done well, will impact other countries positively. But when you're charting a new path, how you chart that path can be onerous because you're doing it for the first time. And for the first time, we have both a normalization committee and a task force. Now, I think we need to be clear, particularly because there's been quite a lot of speculation, understandably so, because people didn't have clarity. So before I make my point of clarity, I would like to say that even if things are still not clear after today, please engage us. Engage for further clarification. Engage to say, okay, this point made was very clear, I need to understand. The normalization committee was set up, has been extended with our three-pronged mandate, and that continues. Within that mandate, the formation of a joint FIFA government task force was clearly stated in this room. And that is to address the specific disciplinary and governance issues. I won't go into detail. But I want us all to leave this room with the clarity that each team has a very clear set of obligations to meet. But the overall responsibility of continuing the normalization process to the end still remains with the normalization committee. And it's important that we all roll up our sleeves and support the teams as we continue to get Ghana football to where we know it can be in the end with positive and strong future. Thank you.